today we have a mathematical treat for all of you guys who like Batman. And let's face it, everybody likes Batman, right? So we're going to calculate the area of this bat wing. And in order to do that, we need some basic information about its dimensions. And we got those from, well, you know who. So, the overall length is 22, the overall height is 8, and the distance between the Batman horns is 2. And if you guys want to try this one for yourself, this is a great time to pause the video and do so, because we're going to get to the solution right now. So, in order to solve this one, we first need to simplify it a little bit. And we're going to do that by drawing this rectangle in the middle. In this way, we're going to divide it into two sections. The first will be this strange shape inside the rectangle, and the second will be those two semicircles outside the rectangle. Let's first take a look at this circle on the right, outside our rectangle. Since the overall height of the Batwing is equal to 8, that means that that is also the diameter of this semicircle. So, the radius of this semicircle must be equal to 4. Of course, the same thing will apply for the semicircle on the left, because those two are identical. Now let's try to find the length of our rectangle. Since the overall length of the Batwing is equal to 22, and these two circles have the radius of 4, that means that the length of our rectangle must be 22 minus 2 times 4, and in this case, that is 14. Now let's try to find the other dimensions for these semicircles inside the rectangle. First, we will take a look at these two violet semicircles. They are also identical, and since the overall length of the rectangle is 14, that means that the diameter of those two must be 14 divided by 2, and that is 7. And since the diameter is equal to 7, that means that the radius must be equal to 3.5. Now let's set our attention to these two green semicircles on the top. And let's try to find their diameter. Since the length of our rectangle is equal to 14, and the distance between bat horns is equal to 2, in order to find this diameter, we need to subtract 14 with 2 and divide it with 2, since there are two of these semicircles. And in this case, that is equal to 6, and that means that the radius of this semicircle is equal to 3, and the same thing applies for the semicircle on the right. And now, the last but not the least, we're left with this little guy between the Batman horns. And since its diameter is equal to 2, that means that the radius of this semicircle must be equal to 1. And there you go, we have some basic dimensions. We're going to clear this up a little bit, and now we're going to try to find the area of this shape. And now I have a little homework for you guys. If you have nothing else to do in your life, and if you want to do some math, you can try to calculate the perimeter of this bat wing using those dimensions on the screen. And if you do that, write your answer down in the comment section below. Alright, let's get back to our bat wing area. First, like we said before, we're going to look at this as a two different areas, one inside the rectangle and one outside the rectangle. Let's calculate the area inside the rectangle first. And let's say that our rectangle is in blue color. So, in order to calculate this inner area, we're first going to need to find the area of this blue rectangle. And from it, we're first going to subtract the area of these two violet semicircles. And since these two semicircles are absolutely identical to each other, we can form one full circle from them. Now let's set our attention to these two semicircles on the top, and of course we will notice that these two guys are also identical, so we can form another full circle. And at the end, the last but not the least, we need to subtract this little semicircle between the Batman horns. So, in order to get our area, we first need to calculate the area of this rectangle, which we can find by multiplying its length and the height, and in our case that is 14 times 8. Now we will find the area of this violet circle, which is equal to r squared pi, and since the radius of this is 3.5, this would be equal to 3.5 squared times pi. Now let's find the area of the green circle. As before, it's r squared pi for the formula, and that is equal to 3 squared pi, since 3 is the radius of this green circle, and this little semicircle guy will be equal to 1 half of the full circle, and that is 1 half of the 1 squared pi. So from here our area 1 will be equal to 14 times 8 minus 3.5 squared times pi minus 3 squared times pi and minus 1 half times 1 squared times pi. Now we can work through this, so this is 112 minus 12.25 times pi minus 9 times pi and minus 0.5 pi. And if we add all pi's together, we're going to get that is 112 minus 21.75 times pi. And since we know that the pi is approximately 3.14, we're going to add that into our calculation, and we're going to get that the area is equal to 112 minus 68.295, and that is equal to 43.705. This is our first area. Now let's find the area of these two semicircles outside the rectangle. If you remember, as we found before, these guys have the radius of 4. And since those two are identical, we can form one full circle from them. So the area will be quite simple. That is r squared pi. And in this case, that is 4 squared pi. So that is 16 times pi. And of course, again, if we substitute the value of pi with 3.14, we're going to get that the area 2 is equal to 50.24. And that is the area of these two semicircles outside our rectangle. And all that is left for us to do is just to add these two areas together. So 43.705 plus 50.24, and the overall area of the bat wing is equal to 93.945, and this is our answer. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, or maybe subscribe to the channel. It would mean a lot. And of course, until next time, see you guys and take care.